Feel the prowess whenever we move, yo, we turn the style up. I'ma just give black powers flowers, whether in the projects or the palace. Even when the pale horse tried to gallop and stir it up, we kept the balance. We move in silence, we move the loudest. Ancestors in my dreams, they move the wildest. They prayed about us, praised and shouted. Picture this country being brave without us. A slave's nostalgia, move through the woods with vigor. When we got free, the world moved with us. Now they wanna change their bodies, go figure. Used to call us, now they wanna be niggas. We the rivers that move through the jungle, yo. When we move, we make the world wonderful.
When we move, the whole world following our path. When we move, the whole world following our path.
And who can move like this? Let me see what I could do right quick. My people were made in whose likeness. Boy, fly niggas ain't never flew like this. Pitch black butterfly from the other side. Somebody's style was lost, it wasn't mine. I'm in a small demographic of real ones dealing with all things classic. King's fabric, linen and silk, from the home of the solid gold, honey and milk. The ones who built it from the mud, soil and sand. A black man, the world in the skin of his hand. Pop de la sop when I shine beyond Stella. Fella, Kwame and Crummer, Mandela, leader, truth teller. The ink well dweller, my pen signs a New York Times bestseller. When I move, y'all move in my wake. BD energy, I generate. How to never move weak, I demonstrate. Celebrating my peeps when I innovate. For my dons and divas, weighing odds and evens to the non believers, vagabonds and heathens, achievers. We ain't satisfied with dreaming. Long as I'm still breathing, watch how
when
I move.
Universal God, Most High, Jah, Cosmic Intelligence, Great Architect, the All. Thank you for allowing myself and my listeners to wake up today full of love in our hearts. Thank you for guiding us to the best possible outcomes for us. Thank you for our health. Thank you for our wealth. Thank you for our knowledge of self. Thank you for all of our healthy organs. Thank you for our healthy hearts. Thank you for our healthy brains. Thank you for our healthy lungs, intestines, pancreases, livers, kidneys. Thank you for today. Thank you for blessings on top of blessings on top of blessings. Thank you for growth. Thank you for insight. Thank you for today. Thank you. Welcome to the Cy Marshall Law Show, episode number 111. Episode 111, that's a special number. I am your gracious host, Cy Marshall Law, and this episode is called Tell People Who You Are. And it's based off law number 5 in my book, I Still Love Her. And that law is, if you don't tell people who you are, they will make up their minds about who you are. Let me say that again. If you don't tell people who you are, they will make up their minds about who you are. This life is yours for the taking. It really is. On every level. And it always starts with what you think about yourself. And from what you think about yourself, you're able to create your reality from that. Because what you think is what you're going to manifest. So with this law, whatever situation you get yourself into, there are going to be other energies besides your own that help create the situation that you're in. But the energy that you vibrate with is going to tell them or give them instruction on how to operate with you. So a lot of times we get into a situation and we don't want to express ourselves because we don't want to become a burden to that situation. We're unsure about how our energy will be received. Because we're unsure of how the response will be of us giving our most honest energy, a lot of times people hide their energies because they're not sure what the response is going to be like. But the issue with that is that when you don't be your true self, you're not allowing the universe to give you all the blessings that are owed to you, because there are doors that you're supposed to open. The only way that door can open is if you're acting as your true self. You can have all these wonderful things happen to you, but if you're refusing to be your true self, you're not allowing the universe to fulfill all the possibilities that could possibly happen in that moment, because you're not showing people who you are. So whatever could happen in a certain timeline, you'll never get to it because you never showed your true self. And a lot of times, you know, it's scary to show our true selves because we don't know what the response is going to be. But some of the most beautiful people on earth are the ones that don't give a fuck. And I don't mean the ones that don't give a fuck to the point where they're making everybody else uncomfortable. I just mean that they're so comfortable in their own skin that whatever they do, however they move, is always truly them. And because of this, when you show your true self, you attract like-minded people. And if you're always hiding your true self, these like-minded people that can be your companions and comrades in life, they'll never show up because you're always hiding your true self. You never, you know, shown who you really are. A lot of times we can be in a situation in life and we can be the best person for a certain opportunity, but we might be afraid of that opportunity. We might be afraid of our own light. And when we're afraid of our own light and we don't embrace who we truly are, it gives people opportunity to tell us who we are because of what they're able to feel from our energy, what they're able to pick up. You know, people are very judgmental. So it's like if you don't give the people the ingredients to who you are, they'll start making up their own recipes in their head and they'll make some old nasty dish and say that's you. This goes across the board, though, in anything you do. You could start a new job and there could be tasks in that job that you know you're able to do. Nobody asks you to do them, so you don't do them. And then someone gets hired to do those jobs and they end up getting paid more money than you because you didn't tell people who you were. You waited for someone to ask you who never did ask you. So someone came in and took your position. So in a different universe, in a different dimension, what happened was you saw things at your job that needed to be done and you didn't wait for someone to tell you who you were. You just did those jobs. You did what needed to be done. And you know what happened? The boss or the CEO or the manager, whoever was, you know, lead in that role, they saw you putting in the extra work because you told them who you were. So when you tell people who you are, they don't have to ask because you're showing them. Because you don't only tell them verbally, you actually show them by your actions. So when you show people who you are, you give them direction on how to treat you. So if you're moving like a boss, if you're making boss moves, people are going to start to treat you like a boss because it's essentially who you are. You know, not everyone, but a lot of people may not want you to shine as brightly as you can shine, because if you do, then they feel like that dims them down, which it actually doesn't. You know what I'm saying? Because I definitely feel as though when you shine a light, you give people license to shine their own light. However, unfortunately, when you shine your light, some insecure people start feeling as though you're coming for them because you're shining your light. But you cannot live your life and dim down your light because someone wants to make you smaller to make them feel bigger. So a lot of people in your lifetime are going to try to make you feel smaller, but you can't allow them to tell you who they are, tell them who you are, because they're only doing that so they can put you in a position that is away from the position you really want to be in, because they want the spot. But what they don't realize is that there's enough room for everybody. You gotta fight for yourself, is really what I'm saying. In this world, if you don't fight for yourself, you will just get eaten alive. People are out there looking to take every spot available. So if you're walking around being humble 24/7, and I'm not saying that being humble is necessarily a bad thing, but what I'm saying is that harsh world out there. So if you're not coming to take your spot, someone else will definitely take it. So you have to come in and say who you are. You got to stick your chest out. You got to look people dead in the eye. You got to straighten your crown. Because if you don't, people will look down on you. They will act like they're better than you. If you act like you're beneath someone, they're definitely going to act like they're better than you. If you act like you're not as good as the next person, they're going to allow you to think that. Because when you start feeling yourself, they start feeling some type of way. But you never felt that way to try to make them feel small. Telling people who you are is more. It's also accountability. Should we hold someone accountable, or should we let something slide? Like, if you've noticed something suspicious, should you let it slide or should you call it out? So when you let it slide, you're not telling people who you are at all. And you gotta understand there's different ways to hold people accountable. So just because you hold someone accountable for doing something foul in your life, it doesn't mean you actually have to say or do anything. It can mean you can stop doing things. It doesn't mean that you have to come for them. It doesn't mean that you have to be mean. It doesn't mean, you know, you don't have to do anything. You can actually just stop doing what you were doing. Stopping sometimes is actually telling people who you are, because it's you with your refusal to put up with their bullshit. That's you telling people who you are. And that's something that I had to find out. Let me say that again. With your refusal to put up with people's bullshit, that is also telling people who you are. Because if you keep allowing everything, if you keep seeing suspicious things go by, if you keep seeing people take shots, and you keep just, you know, putting a smile on your face, they're going to think that's acceptable. So telling people who you are sometimes also is deciding not to say or do anything. Sometimes people don't get the message by you telling them something. Sometimes people don't get the message by you personally showing them something. Sometimes you just have to shut up. And that's the only way the message is received. So shutting up sometimes also is telling somebody who you are. You keep talking, they just can't hear the message. They're just blah, 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 blah. That's all they're hearing. But somehow they can start to hear when you shut up. Somehow. Sometimes people just need space to think. It could be a relationship, with a girlfriend, boyfriend, husband, wife. one of my favorite words is communication in a relationship, because I feel like if I tell you exactly what I want and who I am, then it doesn't give you room to say you weren't told. A lot of times people want you to just be psychic, and to each his own. But I will, for people that I have relationships with, I'm an open book, like, because I want you to understand me. So if we are far down the line and you're moving in ways where I'm like, oh, this person's not paying attention to me, they weren't listening to me, they're not respecting who I am, then it's time for the, you know, relationship to probably die, because I've told this person who I was and they didn't listen. I told them multiple times and they didn't listen. So you also have to, just because you tell someone who you are doesn't mean they're going to listen, but you have to give yourself the opportunity of going into a situation and saying, this is who I am. And if you don't do that, then whatever happens after that, you got to take the consequences. But at least you can say you went into a situation and you showed and you told and you moved in a way that expressed who you were genuinely. You didn't hide who you were. You gave people the opportunity to know the real you. You gave, you know what I'm saying? You gave the universe a chance to give you the possibilities that it had in store for you, because you were your most honest, genuine self. You didn't hide yourself. There's a lot of creating power in what you believe. So if you believe something in your head and you have this idea in your head, and then you get around a situation or an event and you have the opportunity to say what you believe, you should do it. Because there's creating power in your belief. And when you firmly express your belief, I believe that's how you manifest things. It's all in belief. It is what you believe. I read something the other day and they said something along the lines of the greatest way to create, or the greatest power in the universe, they found, was not love, it was authenticity. Meaning that things can come to life, or things do come to life, when they're created from a place of authenticity. They're created from a place of self-belief. Like, if I believe this is who I am, this is who I am. Like, if I believe this in my core, if I believe in my core something certain is going to happen, this is how things come to life. It's self-belief. So take that self-belief that you have and tell people about it. Tell people who you are. Like, don't hide it. Be who you are. The greatest version of yourself. Confidence opens doors. It really does. A lot of times you can have something and you won't have it if you don't ask for it. A lot of times people are waiting for you to ask what you want. They're waiting for you to ask for what you want. And the only thing stopping you is your lack of self-belief, your fear of what the response will be. So you never get what you deserve to get because your fear of what the response was going to be. So confidence opens doors like a magic portal. Confidence is half the battle in anything we do. You deserve to be confident. You are as good as anybody else. Everybody we see hustling and bustling every day, they came into this world just like you. Nobody's better than you. Nobody deserves more than you. Everybody makes mistakes, and nobody's perfect. Therefore, you're allowed to tell people who you are.
because nobody's perfect. So there should be no situation you come into where you have to hide yourself. Because you are great. You're as great as the next person. I don't care what they do or what they've done. We all came here the same way. So it's okay for you to tell people who you are. Because who you are is beautiful. The only way, you know what? The only way they're not going to see you as beautiful is if you don't believe that. It's like me teaching my kids how to catch a ball. I'll throw a ball, you know, when they're small, I'll throw a ball at them and the ball might hit them in the face. And I say to them, yo, the only reason that shit hit you in the face is because you closed your eyes. You didn't believe. You have to believe. Open your eyes to what's really going on. And you'll catch that ball every time. Be confident or else that ball is going to hit you in the face. This is life. Tell people who you are. Tell people what you want. Because that ball is going to come to you and you sticking out your hands and acting like you want what you really want is going to allow you to catch that ball. And I know that's a small metaphor, but it is. It can go big for all areas of life. Open your eyes and catch that ball. It's okay to express what you really want. It could be like a girl you want. It could be a guy you want. And if you don't open up your mouth and express yourself and allow the universe to make the decisions on what's going to happen, that situation can never happen. Give yourself a shot. Give yourself a shot. The possibilities are endless. And whatever is bad you think might happen or could happen, it usually never happens. Whatever you're terrified of usually never happens. So just believe. Believe in yourself. Believe that you're going to land on your feet regardless. Or believe, even if you don't land on your feet, believe that the universe loves you enough for you to know that you're going to get back up again. Like it's going to be all right. Like no matter what. You can walk through the fire and you're going to come out on the other end. A lot of people come up to a situation and their truth says that they're going to have to walk through fire. So they don't want to be their truth. They don't want to express their truth because their truth tells them the only way to get better or the only way to get past a current situation that might be hard for them is for them to express their truth. They can't hide anymore. They're going to have to go through their truth, and sometimes their truth is the fire. But that's okay. It's like the phoenix. You go down, you're going to come back higher. You're going to come back with more life. Sometimes that fire is you just allowing people to see you as you really are. It might hurt sometimes. It might not hurt. But that's growth. That could be for, you know, being happy or hurt. If you're hurt, sometimes people try to hide the fact that they're hurt. And it's hard for them to heal when they're hiding the fact that they're hurt. So even with that, tell people who you are. If you want to get better, tell people who you are. So they know, so they can act accordingly. We have so many people out here just hiding their true feelings. And when you're hiding your true feelings, it only festers inside of you. It doesn't go anywhere. Get it out. Get those feelings out, homeboy. Nah, get it out. Get those feelings out, homegirl. Get those feelings out, homeboy. Because they only fester and they end up rotting. It's not a good look. And they end up, those feelings end up coming out in horrible ways later on in life. You end up taking out your miseries or your disappointments out on people that don't deserve it. Because back when you had the opportunity to express who you really were, you never did it. And then that made you upset on the inside because you didn't express who you truly were. You had the opportunity to say who you really were and you didn't say it. You suppressed that feeling. And because you suppressed that feeling, you know you did yourself wrong. So you're mad on the inside. And you're not going to go back to that situation and, you know, rear up on that situation. You're just going to hold that madness on the inside and you're going to give it to somebody else that doesn't deserve it. Because you suppressed who you really were. So you were mad at yourself. That's why you have to tell people who you are. This is your life. This is your life.
I came up in a time where everybody was rapping real hard, but now I can't tell these rappers apart. I came to compete, though my brain it hurts. I'm a bucket spray. I brought enough heat to make the rain reverse and go the other way. Y'all don't know what to do, looking wobbly. But I'm a top MC, coming true like a prophecy. I'm not giving up, though the game it seems trash. I'ma fight like playing Power Stone on Dreamcast. These dudes are my sons, I try to keep class. But if it comes to it, I'm burning my seeds like cheap grass. The King Messiah, I rap for real, you better learn and train. I spit fire like the back of the Batmobile's burst of flame. These dudes are less, I think they're applying pressure. But I wasn't sweating a sweater in 100 degree weather. Wearing a leather, playing soccer, scoring a header. I'm the measure, the treasure can't end me, I am forever. You tried to flex when you were Tyrone. Storm from the X-Men couldn't make a cyclone. And if you thought I wouldn't leave this mic blown, you probably thought you could call God with your iPhone. I rap like my mom cussing over percussion. Who you jumping? I'm on point like Jalen Brunson. You better leave the chat when I join the discussion. It's ever living sound, we always getting into something.
Yeah, and if you got it confused, well that's bad news. Cause ain't nobody playing with you.
Playing with you.
They been acting brand new, that's the damn truth.
Shoot.
But ain't nobody playing with you. Hold up, you know the spotlight so bright, forged by the fire like a diamond in the sunlight. Right, so if you got it confused, well that's bad news. Cause ain't nobody playing with you.
I'm not really feeling this comedy rap. Ever living gon' help bring the quality back. With homegrown skills you probably lack. With those weak rhymes you making a mockery jack. I try quitting, ain't nothing stopping these tracks. So now I'll just teach you all how to properly rap. No clickbait so you can follow me back. What you getting for streams is robbery scraps. They better start paying up properly facts. Times is tough for the artist, so it gotta be that. If you continue to do things the wrong way, for you and your people it's gonna be a long day. I ain't impressed if you don't hear my song play. Oh, see, I'll go to the crib and smoke a strong J and think up ways to find another form of pay. I'ma keep riding, I'm going all the way.
Yeah, and if you got it confused, well that's bad news. Cause ain't nobody playing with you.
Playing with you.
They been acting brand new, that's the damn truth.
Shoot.
But ain't nobody playing with you. Hold up, you know the spotlight so bright, forged by the fire like a diamond in the sunlight. Right, so if you got it confused, well that's bad news. Cause ain't nobody playing with you.
Remember, if you're enjoying the show, please subscribe. It helps us out. To get back right into the topic, episode 111, tell people who you are.
Unfortunately, not everybody's a good person, and too many people are selfish, so they won't stop to consider you. They won't stop to, well, not everyone, but a lot of people won't stop to say, this person hasn't told me who they are, so let me try to find out who they are. A lot of people will not do that. They have so much going on in their own lives that you're giving them a task to think about yours. So if you give them that task, they're just going to put you in the fastest, easiest box. And sometimes maybe it's selfish. Maybe, you know, you should have just told them who you are. Maybe they didn't want to be psychic that day. Maybe your problem is not their problem. Maybe they have their own problems. So when we're getting upset at people sometimes for not treating us how we feel we should be treated, sometimes we need to just tell them how we need to be treated. Because sometimes people are not thinking about us at all. And that could be for selfish reasons, or that could just be because they have things on their plate and they're not thinking about you like that. Maybe they need to be, maybe they don't need to be. But the fact that what you need is not getting done is your responsibility. If you need something done a certain way, you gotta handle that. Life is too short for you to be complaining or blaming someone else for an issue because you're waiting for them to know something that you haven't even told them about yourself. Like, you got to tell people who you are. Like, it's imperative if you want to create some type of reality that you're going to be comfortable with. Like, it's your responsibility. It's your life. And you don't need more than yourself. Like, you are enough. You're not lacking in anything. You are who you are. You just have to realize that your type of special is worth as much as the next person's special. And if someone doesn't vibe with you, that's okay. Because there is a whole lot of people that have your similar type of special that will vibe with you. But you're never going to find those people if you don't tell people who you are. I see a lot of kids nowadays, to me, they seem as though they're not expressing themselves that much. I feel like the whole TV, social media thing is, you know, just taking a lot of our generation, this new generation of kids. And I feel like because of that, it's stopping them from really finding out who they are, because they're just so much into social media and so much into like the video games or just in entertainment, just celebrities, just social media, I suppose, in general. And because you're feeding so much into that, it's like you know, you are what you eat. And if you're always on social media, if you're always in the entertainment industry, if you're always listening to this music, that music, watching this movie, that movie, if you're always, you know, feeding yourself some type of something that is not always good for you, it's going to be hard for you to tell people who you are, because you're not going to know, because you're feeding yourself so much other bullshit. Do you even know who you are? You go online and you scrolling and scrolling and scrolling and you scrolling, and everything you see, it's not like you're just scrolling past it. Everything you see, you're taking it with you. Everything you read, you're taking it with you. Everything you watch, you're taking it with you. Yes, you are what you eat. You are what you read. You are what you watch. So when I say tell people who you are, do you even know who you are? Who takes a break to not consume social media? Or who takes a break to not consume what they're being told? Who takes a break to differentiate their ideas from the next man's ideas? Who takes a break to be quiet for 10 minutes, 20 minutes, 30 minutes, an hour? So who do you even know who you are? Because you're listening to all this music, you watching all these movies, you watching every episode, you on every social media app, you're just consuming and consuming and consuming and consuming. So I'm here telling you, tell people who you are, or they'll make up their minds about who you are. But you have to understand, life in general is consistently, frequently trying to tell you who you are through the shows you're watching, through the people you're communicating with, through the music you're listening to, through the food you're eating, through all of your interactions. Life is trying to tell you who you are. So you literally have to consciously step back and see what you want to take in and see what you want to keep out. Because if you don't tell people who you are, if you don't tell situations what you are, they will tell you for you. You're just going to be taken and taken and taken. And when you look in the mirror, everything you've taken, you're not really going to be able to see you because you've just taken so much. It's like you went grocery shopping without bags. I was saying the other day on one of my posts, I can't stand how they took bags out of all the stores of plastic bags, but I know it was for nature and the earth. But anyway, I was saying it's like you're taking and taking and taking, and you have all these items in your hand with no bag. Then you try to look into the mirror to see, like, you know, yourself, but you can't even see yourself because you just have all these things in your hands. So it's like, who are you? Sometimes you have to, and that's what one of my favorite phrases is, empty hands. Empty hands. Sometimes it's hard to see yourself when your hands are full, when you have so many bags, when you got so much baggage, when you're carrying so much on the inside, so many chips on your shoulders. It's hard to see the real you. So how are you going to tell people who you are when you're carrying so much inside, you're carrying so much on your back? So sometimes you got to let it go in order for you to tell people who you are. Sometimes you don't know who you are because you're carrying so much. So that would be one of my first suggestions, to let go whatever you're carrying, or let go of that chip so you can really see who you are. And one of my best ways to clarify myself is to be quiet. Quietness. There's so much gold in quietness. There's so much silence. Excuse me. There's so much golden. Goldenness in silence. Silence. What am I trying to say here? You know what I'm trying to say. Silence is golden. There's a lot of jewels to be found in silence, is what I'm saying here. And as soon as we wake up during a day, it's hard to have our own thoughts if as soon as we wake up, we're going on social media. As soon as we wake up, we're listening to what our employers want to say. We're listening to our friends' problems. We're listening to, like, just the hustle and bustle of life. Like, who are we? Soon as we wake up, things is popping. So how can we even say who we are if as soon as we wake up, the world is trying to give us who we are immediately? And that could be our own children. It could be our jobs. It could be our sports teams. So you need to be able to step away and to see, you know, really what's going on in order for you to clearly tell people who you are. You have to make sure you're not holding so much of other people's things that you're not even sure anymore if they're their things or if they're your things. You're just holding all these things now. So now you can't differentiate who you are. And therefore, when you can't differentiate who you are from the next person, your ideas from theirs, people will just start telling you who you are because it's not clear to them who you are. So they're going to put you in the box they want to put you in. This is what happens. These are the facts. My name is Sy Martial Law, and this is Sy Martial Law Show. We will be back after these messages. Now, I always wanted to say that I don't got no messages yet. Maybe I'll start doing ads soon. Maybe not. Probably not. We'll see. We're going to get into a song. My name is Sy Martial Law, and we're going to come back and talk some more.
Sweet sounds and a smile and a rhythm.
Mic check. Smooth to any groove.
Just watch in a graceful and moving sense.
Relax the tongue, let my mic take a cruise around the
sweet
planet.
Sweet something is smiling and grooving.
Mic check, I can get smooth to any groove.
Just watch in a graceful and moving sense.
Relax the tongue, let my mic take a cruise around the
Michael
planet.
Michael McDonald, sweet freedom in my speakers. With business, I'm an elitist, but bitches still buy me sneakers. Cause I'm about 24 centimeters, attitude of a genius, so guess who hit in the deepest? Sailboats at dawn, a manicured lawn, a Barry Manilow song, man, I could go on. I'm Tony Danza when he moved out the Fairfield. 87 Nikes telling friends how the air feel. Porsche on the back road, leaves falling slowly. My frequency is holy, now the devil can't control me. I radiate charisma, I'm working on my karma. Getting in that cardio, then roasting in that sauna. Moving molecules with the words I choose. We paraglide at sunset for the birds I views. I made peace with the Lord, exterminated my demons. Now I'm all city, all star, all all seasons. You'll be on that jail bus, smuggling a stale Dutch, while I be ripping rappers like sharks eating whale guts. Steven Spielberg called me Bruce. You have to Google that one, or you'll be all confused. I'm on the Doc Dawn's light, putting bait on ice. I got a few punchlines, but rap's based on life. Opposition sneak dissing, throwing sprays on mics. Yeah, right. Allow me to lace my Nikes. I raise the price.
Mic check. I can get smooth to any groove.
Just watching a gracefully moving sense.
Relax the tongue. Let my mic take a cruise around the
sweet
planet.
Sweet something is smiling and grooving.
Mic check. I can get smooth to any groove.
Just watching a gracefully moving sense.
Relax the tongue. Let my mic.
We riding out like Pequot, Montauk, ocean, coasting. Lighthouse spinning through fog in slow motion. Cops on State Street breaking up the commotion. I'm out at Rocky Neck applying suntan lotion. Relaxing in peace. Do something steal raps and beats like seagulls steal snacks at the beach where the fishermen hail from. We stash our bail funds until your girl find it, then the bitch get her nails done. Grew up on straight beef, app is quite vicious. Mad drunk uncles giving natty light business. Multifamily cribs with the satellite dishes. Puerto Rican accent on half the white bitches. Classic rock out the Ford stock speakers. We got a lot of Uncle Mikes and Aunt Lisa's. Fist fights over best spots for pizzas and rosaries hang with the mini pictures of Jesus. My Steve Winwood tapes help me escape. Drop anchor at the Cape and absorb the landscape. Handshakes with the rich from the dough we made. But I could tell they really hating with the low-key shade. It's all positive, no more narcotics raids. It's all profit, no more financial aid. I skyrocketed right off the front of the stage and bought property, a prophecy I finally changed. I'm in range.
Mic check, I can get smooth to any groove.
Just watching a gracefully moving sense.
Relax the tongue, let my mic take a cruise around the
sweet
planet.
Sweet something is smiling and grooving.
Mic check, I can get smooth to any groove.
Just watching a gracefully moving sense.
Relax the tongue, let my mic take a cruise around the planet.
So, I'm gonna get into the book reading. My book reading, I Still Love Her. 52 Laws of Freedom, the Psiography. I'm going to read Law 5, which is, as you all know, if you don't tell people who you are, they will make up their minds about who you are. It is a competitive world, and I had to learn the hard way that sometimes it's the closest people to you, or maybe people you don't even know, who are competing with you, as if to say there is not enough room for everyone to have their own shine. But there always is. I was always taught to be humble, and for the most part, I think I was. But in haste to climb to the top of the mountain, but in haste to climb to the top of the entertainment industry, I abruptly found out that being good was just not good enough. For years, I would go to shows and give my heart on stage, then step off stage as if I didn't know I had just smashed the performance. My fellow artists who knew very well what happened at my shows would act as if they didn't see my performances. Silence is all I heard. That is until I began carrying the presence of a man who knew who he was instead of a man searching for some type of co-signing. I gave myself my own co-sign without being overly arrogant, but just confident. My alleged competition and others alike soon began to notice as opportunities started coming faster than ever before. Also, a buzz about me began to build in the musical scenes I was frequenting. I had another experience years later when I became a network engineer. Because of my quiet nature at the job, although doing a great job, nobody knew what I was really capable of because I stuck to myself beyond my own team. Because of this, I noticed I became the second go-to guy as opposed to the first. The first engineer was loud, though very kind. He was known to voice his opinion and get involved in everything he could. He let people know who he was. Eventually, that first engineer, he went on to win awards, as where I went on to leave the company. My old company had decided on who I was already because it is what I had shown them. The verse, believe this, verse 1. Work through the day and see what the night brings. I believe we should all live like kings, but never ever sell your soul for nice things. I wanna build schools that teach the right things. So kids say, I wanna be like him. But money comes and goes like wind. And broke's no fun. I like to spend dollars, and the truth is I'm not trying to owe one. Live while you're alive and not dead. The jewel is, do what you love and make bread. Listen to your heart and not what they said. Dudes can talk, food for thought, I stay fed. Mars the man. But I'm trying to help homeless people living out of a garbage can. I told you, my rhyme's so true, but I can't do that if I'm broke too. The breakdown. Many people spend their lives giving blood, sweat, and tears to a company where the owner may not even care to know their name. I started this song off with a line that I believe is at my core. If you do the work, you should get and you deserve blessings that come with doing the job. 2. But never ever sell your soul for nice things. I wanna build schools that teach the right things. So kids say, I wanna be like him. But money comes and goes like wind. The things we cannot see are worth the most. For instance, the soul is priceless. Some people trade their souls, conform, take less than their worth, or go morally against who they are for money and some type of physical glory. At the end of the day, we can't take with us material or physical things. So one should not sell that which is priceless for something that can be bought and runs out. Happiness is easier to find when you are true to yourself. And sometimes all the material things in the world will still not make you happy. But being yourself will. 3. I'm broke's no fun. I like to spend dollars, and the truth is I'm not trying to owe one. Live while you're alive and not dead. Although we are spiritual beings living an earthly existence, we are still human. We are here to experience life on the physical plane. For this reason, one should never hold disdain for another only because they value some material possessions, for we live in a material world. Being spiritual does not mean you have to denounce the ways of the physical realm. Only keep in mind, what is truly real cannot be seen with the physical eye. 4. The jewel is, do what you love and make bread. Listen to your heart and not what they said. Dudes can talk, food for thought, I stay fed. Mars the man. But I'm trying to feed homeless people living out of a garbage can. I told you, my rhyme's so true, but I can't do that if I'm broke too. I feel that if you can find a way to serve the world with your gift, combine that with the love of your work, and release attachment to any particular outcome, then you can only land on your feet. You need money to survive, but you need love and happiness to thrive. Only doing what you love without having a way to be financially stable causes a tear in priorities. So a vision is needed that brings together all the parts of what you need. I've been in situations where I did what I love, but not getting a penny for it. Conversely, I've been in cases where I made a sizable amount of finances, but I was not happy. The key to life is finding that balance.
Yeah. So that ends our show for today. I want to end with our quote of the day as usual. So the quote of today that I felt was fitting, being that we're talking about telling people who you are and what you'll miss out on if you don't do that. The quote of the day is, it's anonymous, or I don't know where it's from. I actually looked online. I couldn't figure out where it's from. I've just always known it. And it's a great quote. Take this with you today and just think about it, how it applies to your life. So today's Sign Martial Law Show quote of the day is, you cannot pick up diamonds if you have rocks in your hand.
My name is Simon Shalaw. Please do share, subscribe, and I'll see y'all next week. Peace, love, and positive energy. And I'm out like that.